From the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel, with the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Mail. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from three donors. The first is Irene Remedius from Scarborough, Ontario, for the repose of the soul of her husband, Albert, for her personal intentions and for family members to strengthen their faith. The second is the Gomez family from Scarborough, Ontario, in memory of Anthony Gomez, who passed away in March 2019, and for the living and deceased members of the Gomez and the Souza families, in thanksgiving for blessings received and for the souls in purgatory who have no one to pray for them. The third is an anonymous donor from Markham, Ontario, in loving memory of her mother and on the first anniversary of her passing today, or thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord on this Thursday, again recalling that we're weak, just like Saint Turbius was in the 16th century, knowing that all power comes from God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who gave increase to your church through the apostolic labors and zeal for truth of the Bishop Saint Turbius, grant that the people consecrated to you may always receive new growth in faith and holiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. After the Lord God had finished giving the tablets of the covenant to Moses on Mount Sinai, the Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people, whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt, have acted perversely. They have been quick to turn aside from the way that I commanded them. They have cast for themselves an image of a calf, and have worshipped it and sacrificed to it, and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I have seen this people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone, so that my wrath may burn hot against them, and I may consume them, and of you I will make a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord his God and said, "O Lord, why does your wrath burn hot against your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with great power and with a mighty hand? Why should the Egyptians say, 'It was with evil intent that he brought them out to kill them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth'? Turn from your fierce wrath, change your mind, and do not bring disaster on your people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them by your own self, saying to them, 'I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have promised I will give to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever.' And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster that he planned to bring on his people." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, remember us for the love you bear your people. Our ancestors made a calf at Horeb and worshipped a cast image. They exchanged the glory of God for the image of an ox that eats grass. Lord, remember us for the love you bear your people. They forgot God, their Savior, who had done great things in Egypt, wondrous works in the land of Ham, and awesome deeds by the Red Sea. Lord, remember us for the love you bear your people. Therefore God said he would destroy them had not Moses, his chosen one, stood in the breach before him to turn away his wrath from destroying them. Lord, remember us for the love you bear your people. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. God loved the world so much, he gave us his only Son, that all who believe in him might have eternal life. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
The Jewish leadership were seeking to kill Jesus because he was not only breaking the Sabbath, but was also calling God his own Father, thereby making himself equal to God. Jesus said to them, "If I testify about myself, my testimony is not true. There is another who testifies on my behalf, and I know that his testimony to me is true. You sent messengers to John, and he testified to the truth. Not that I accept such human testimony, but I say these things so that you may be saved. He was a burning and shining lamp, and you were willing to rejoice for a while in his light. But I have a testimony greater than John's, the works that the Lord has given me to complete, the very works that I am doing, testify on my behalf that the Father has sent me. And the Father who sent me has himself testified on my behalf. You have never heard his voice or seen his form, and you do not have his word abiding in you, because you do not believe him who has sent. You search the scriptures because you think that in them you have eternal life, and it is they that testify on my behalf. Yet you refuse to come to me to have life. I do not accept glory from human beings, but I know that you do not have the love of God in you. I have come in my Father's name, and you do not accept me. If anyone comes in his own name, you will accept him. How can you believe when you accept glory from another and do not seek the glory that comes from the one who alone is God? Do not think that I will accuse you before the Father. Your accuser is Moses, on whom you have set your hope. If you believe If you believed Moses, you would believe me, for he wrote about me. But if you do not believe what he wrote, how will you believe what I say? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And the argument goes on. Of course, Jesus, chapter 5 of the Gospel of John is actually one big long argument after Jesus healed on a Sunday, or on a Sabbath, I'm sorry, and they tried to catch him on that. It is about following all the little rules and having some pastoral sensitivity. But of course, the bottom line is Jesus has to go. And this is a big problem for all leaders. Anyone who is a leader, there's always people out to get them. Always people to get out to get them. And yes, how do I lead a flock? And if it doesn't matter if it is a bishop or the Pope or a parish priest, they set the tone for the people. And so there's always will be opposition because people don't like power. And unless they are in power, they like power, but there's always a resistance. And the same was in the first reading of Moses. Moses, of course, is leading the people through the desert, and the people, of course, they whine and cry, and there's always something. And in this account, he comes from the mountain, and he was too long gone, and the people made their own god, a golden calf. And we have Moses pleading with God, intercessory prayer, pleading with God, have mercy on these people. The task of a leader, while often, same in Moses' time, he's pleading for the people while the people are working against him. How common we see is also in our world, today. There's this tension always. And this leads me to Saint Turbius, the optional for today. He was a bishop in Lima in the 16th century. And also he was sent in very difficult mission work. Actually, it's an interesting account. I invite you even go to Wikipedia, there'll be a whole account, to look him up. We could say his appointment was by Simony. You know, in those days it was always about power and buying titles and so on. And before he even was a priest, he was leading the Inquisition in Spain. He was leading the Inquisition in Spain, obviously someone who really followed the rules and so on. But he obviously must have also had a heart. And he made a name for himself. And it's a different time than today. Philip II, King Philip II of Spain, appointed him Archbishop of Lima in Peru. And he did not want it, but the Pope Gregory XIII, he approved it. And against his will, he had to accept. But he was not even a priest. So they quickly ordained him before shipping him off to Lima. But in Lima, that's where he did the great work. It's a time, frontier environment. The Spanish who came there, they used and abused the native people and so on. Just whatever sin was possible, it was possible there. But he was sent there to clean it up, so to speak. And I guess the King Philip II recognized his gift of cleaning things up. And so he is there, and he apparently went on foot, made three times he visited every parish in his diocese, on foot. Enormous amount of energy. His motto was, time is not our own. And we must give a strict account of it. He really felt that every minute of his life was important to build the kingdom of God. And he obviously created a beautiful environment, set the tone for the flock. And He baptized and confirmed Rose of Lima, Saint Rose of Lima today, and also he baptized and confirmed Martin de Porres, one of the great saints too of that era. And so he really set the tone. And this is really the task of a bishop. And in 2 days in Toronto, we have Archbishop Frank Leo will be installed. And he, of course, takes over from the wonderful work Cardinal Thomas has done. But again, he has to set the tone, a new tone, for today's issues in the Diocese of Toronto. An immense task. We look on it as, oh, the bishop, he won the prize. But it's an immense undertaking to take on all that responsibility, because there's always opposition, and he will have to deal with that opposition, and it sometimes comes in ways we don't expect. And the media, of course, we know in our own environment, the media are always trying to dig for dirt and do the work. So, of course, we pray for Archbishop Frank Leo, that by the grace of God, he will be blessed with holy insight and stamina as he takes over the reins from Cardinal Thomas Collins on March 25th as leader of the Archdiocese of Toronto. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in a prayer intention book, especially those seeking a deeper awareness of God in their life this Lenten season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray this month for those who have suffered harm from members of the Church. May they find within the Church herself a concrete response to their pain and suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the reposed souls of all our TV member community members who have gone before us, as they have generally made this ministry possible. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Turribius, that, bestowing on us your pardon, our oblation may give honor to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Turribius, you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all you have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. Renewed by these sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Turibius, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught, through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
We gather.